side for you. Okay, the first step is we're going to find the reference angle. Then we're going to label our opposite, adjacent, and hypotenuse based on that reference angle. Then we're going to decide which trig function we're going to use when we're going to set it up. So the first part I'm going to show you is just how to do these four steps. Then on the second page, we're going to go through actually solving those. Okay, so let's look at this setup. We want to use this 52 degree angle as our reference angle. So from this 52 degree angle, this side is the opposite. This side is the hypotenuse. So that means the side that's labeled 12 is my adjacent side. Okay, so which two sides are we using? Well, there's no marking, there's no length, and our X is not on the hypotenuse, so we're not going to use hypotenuse. We're going to use the opposite side and the adjacent side. So go back and look at your reference. Which trig ratio, I'll jot them up here, opposite, hypotenuse, adjacent, hypotenuse, opposite, adjacent. Which one uses the opposite side in the adjacent side? Well, that's our tangent. So that's how we decide which trig function to use. So let's set up the tangent of theta. Well, theta in this case is our reference angle. So we're taking the tangent of 52 degrees. And that's equal to the opposite side over the adjacent side. So now we're going to write a ratio. Opposite is X, we don't know that side. Adjacent is 12. And that is how we set it up. So there's our first, there's the first part. So let's go down and we're just going to practice setting these first three problems up. Not solving them yet, just setting them up. So I'm going to jot this down for later. We have the tangent of 52 is equal to 12 over X. Okay, so now let's look at this practice problem here. So here's our right triangle. We have a 48 degree angle here. So that's our reference angle. We've got 17 on this side and X on this side. So from this reference angle, which two sides are we dealing with? These two. So from here, this side X is the opposite. And the side that's marked 17 is the hypotenuse. Okay, so we had sine, cosine. Let me jot those down again. I'll try not to erase them this time. And which trig function uses the opposite and the hypotenuse? Well, that's the sine function, okay? Because it's sine is opposite and hypotenuse. So I'm going to set up the sine of what angle? What's my reference angle? It is 48 degrees. And that's equal to the opposite. So my opposite is my unknown. So it's on top. And my hypotenuse is on the bottom. And the hypotenuse is 17. So the first problem is going to be the sine of 48 is equal to X over 17. Okay? Let's try the third one, or the second practice problem on your second page. Let's see. We have a 72 degree reference angle. We've got 34 over here. We have X over here. So from the 72 degree angle, X is our opposite. This is our hypotenuse. And this one is our adjacent. Okay, so we're not using hypotenuse. So which one uses opposite and adjacent? Opposite adjacent is tangent. Opposite and adjacent. So let's see if you can do this. We're going to set up the tangent of what angle? Tangent of 72 is equal to the ratio of which two sides? Opposite over adjacent. So I'm going to have X over 34. So this one sets up as the tangent of 72 is equal to X over 34. Okay, let's look at the third.